Hello everyone and welcome to VAN Tech Corner. In this video, we will increase the router's 1-2-LAN throughput with flow offloading. Before the configuration, let's have a check on the DIR-842C2 throughput with flow offloading on and off. This is the DIR-842C2. The one port is configured in DHCP mode. Currently, flow offloading is disabled. Let's start the speed test. We have 260 Mbps for download and the CPU uses it 100%. The result is the same for the second test. Now, let's go to network, firewall, and enable software flow offloading. With software flow offloading enabled, we were able to reach 686 Mbps with the CPU fully utilized. Compared with the result we have for flow offloading disabled, the throughput increased by 2.5 times. It is a huge difference. Before we move on, let's find out what is network offloading and flow offloading. OpenWRT used the Linux kernel network stack to process the network packets, including NAT, routing, PPPoE, etc. And it is using the CPU power to process all of them. For example, during the network address translation or NAT, when the packets are going from your LAN device with an internal IP address to the internet with a public IP address, the router will replace the source IP address from the internal IP address to the public IP address, and vice versa. This is one of the reasons the CPU uses of the router increase when downloading or uploading a file. Now, in order to reduce the CPU workload, we will offloading the task. According to Wikipedia, computation offloading is the transfer of resource-intensive computational task to a separate processor, such as a hardware accelerator or an external platform. In networking, besides CPU, we can handle network packets with hardware, either a SoC with built-in hardware accelerator, for example the MediaTek MT7621A, or with the network interface card. Depends on to which device we are offloading the task, this action is called L2 or Layer 2 offloading or L3 offloading. Bridging, multicast forwarding, and VLAN translations are happening in the layer 2 of the OSI network model, and when offloading the task, we call L2 offloading. The same for L3 offloading, where we use the hardware accelerator feature to offload NAT, routing, and PPPoE. Now, let's back to OpenWRT. Layer 3 network offloading was officially supported since OpenWRT 18.06. Most of it is software offloading. Hardware offloading is limited to a few devices or SoC. So what is flow offloading? As mentioned earlier, OpenWRT used the Linux networking stack which consists of 7 layers to process the package. But with flow offloading, we are about to create a fast path to bypass certain layers or package processing process. As a result, we have a higher throughput and reduce the CPU loaded. If you are interested to learn more about networking offloading in OpenWRT, you can take a look on this document from Hout-Mettent. Or else, this article from Red Hat blog will also help to explain more about it. Now, let's do another test with the Linksys WRT1900AC. With software flow offloading enabled, we have 900 Mbps throughput with the CPU at 42% idle. When turning flow offloading off, the CPU usage increases and we only have 17% CPU idle with the same throughput. We can see that flow offloading helps to reduce the workload of the WRT1900 CPUs by 1.5 times. That's all for this video. I hope it will be useful when you are looking for a solution to increase your WAN to LAN throughput and reducing the CPU throttle to have some resources to run all the tasks. Please bear in mind that flow offloading may not compatible with SQM and QoS, so when you are turning on flow offloading, SQM, QoS may not work as expected. And by the way, if you see any wrong information in these videos, please leave a comment and I would like to know and learn more about it. Thanks for watching and I will see you all in the next video. Bye bye.